world searching for gaming knowledge comes the man, the myth, a legend in his own mind, Critical.
Welcome back, everybody. Critical here, and I'm bringing you a first look of Conan Exiles. Now, I've already got my server set up. I'm playing a co-op solo game. My character name is Miranda. If anybody can get the reference, go ahead and put it down in the comments. I'd love to see if anybody gets it. I am playing a Shemite, if I'm saying that correctly. They're good with bows. I want to do a ranged character. And I'm accused of selling a virgin, defecating on a statue, and fixing gladiator matches. A little disconcerting, some of those. Okay, here we go. Oh, before I get started, to anybody out there that's having problems with Conan, a couple things I found out. When I first loaded up this game, I was having so many problems with lag and audio issues. And I was frustrated to the point that I even considered maybe returning it. I don't want to do that. I love this game. I like what it's got. It needs some work. But I talked to a friend of mine and I tried some stuff out, and it turns out that at the time I was trying to do this, I had just installed GForce Experience, so I had its recording, it's called Shadowplay, trying to work in the background. I had OBS working in the background, and then I had the Steam overlay working. Now, I wasn't using it, but it was in the background. It was available. Okay, that's just way too much stuff. So I uninstalled the GForce Experience. I turned off every Steam overlay, including the FPS counter. I restarted the computer, and now everything is to be working good. I mean, I wasn't saying I was trashing the game in my first try at this, but I definitely wasn't happy, and I was wanting it to be well known. But it turns out it was all on my end. So anybody that's having problems with the game, especially if you're trying to solo, check and see if that Steam overlay, could be a lot of what the problem is, because that takes resources, and you know, it all adds up. So here we go. Now, every time I've started the game so far, I haven't had this cutscene actually play the voiceover. Now, I know I've heard the voiceover on other people's videos, but it's not showing up for me. I don't know. Let's see what happens this time. No, I'm still not getting the voice. Now, I do have the music turned off. It might be because I have the music turned off, and I'll put an annotation. I'll check this later again with the music on. That overlay might be part of, or that voice might be part of some music track. And maybe that's why I'm not hearing it. See, I'm glad I'm doing this again. I'm learning as I go, and you get to learn with me. I get to look like an idiot, and you get to learn all the cool stuff that I find. Okay, so the first thing I like to do is roll my mask wheel back so I can look at my character. Alright, there's the vanity shot. By pushing V, I can vanity shot. She's attractive. Don't mind anything that you see here. Oh, damn! Interior view! Oh! Did not know I could do that. Once again, I said I find all the cool stuff. Alright. It's a survival game. So, food, water. Now, because I had an uninstalled GForce Experience. Aha! Sorry about that, the graphics look kind of horrible. I was wondering why the creation screen, the hair looked like 1950s graphics. I know, not even possible, but I'm a jokester, what can I say? Now, there's this rock over here when you first load in.
I am beaten, left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here, slaves, bandits and cannibals, exiles from lands I've never heard of. Some of them try to scrape a life from the wasteland, scrabbling in the rocks and sand for their own place. I cannot go on. The life that I left behind haunts me. The sun with the glittering spires of Belverus has forever denied me. The smell of my daughter's hair. I will pass the ghost fence, and this cursed land will finally end me. To whoever reads this note, I leave the last of my water and this message. Stranger, you have my pity. You do not know how cursed you truly are.
I let you listen to that. I didn't want to interrupt it. I'm going to let you listen to this. But as this plays, I'm going to go ahead and run off. I want to see something real quick. It's that amulet that's on her wrist, which is allowing this obelisk to
behold,
speak to us.
The very boundaries of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways, lie the wild places of the world, where untamed savages make endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it. Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads lead to the city.
So basically, it's this game's way of telling you, get moving, find a road, follow it, and go to the city. I don't suggest you do that on your first day. You're not going to make it to the city. Now, what I'm running around doing is picking up rocks and stones, and I'm gathering bugs. You can eat the bugs. It's not the greatest food source, but at least it's something. I just gained a level. We'll do the levels here in just a few minutes. I just want to collect all this stuff because these first few sticks and bushes are really important. And my water and my food is constantly going down. Now, you can individually keep hitting the E if you want, but you can just hold, this game is set up, you can actually just hold E, go to a harvestable item, and she just sits there and keeps grabbing at it. Now, I've played very, very little Ark. I picked it up, I logged into it, it didn't grab me, so I didn't really play it. I know a lot of people are comparing this game to Ark. So what? I like this so far. I don't know, I'm a picky gamer, I guess. Or it just didn't do it for me. Alright. I've got a good amount of plant fibers, so I'm going to go ahead and start crafting some clothing. Now, as I craft these items, she's going to put them on instantly. I don't have to manually go put them on. So I'm going to go ahead and get a stone pick and my clothing crafted up. And I'll craft a torch. I won't be utilizing it right away, but get it crafted. And still, gather, gather, gather. Now, as you can see, if you watch the XP, boom, every time you gather, every moment you're alive in the world and you're not dead, you're getting experience. Now, tiny, tiny amount of experience, I believe, is what's being gained from just surviving in the game. But gathering gives you experience, crafting gives you experience, fighting, killing, surviving all gives you experience. Don't worry about that noise, it's not anything that's gonna hurt you. But I just wanna make sure I have enough plant fibers and sticks to get me going. Some of the first things you want to do is, once you get into the starter area, because this is kind of like the long hallway leading up to the starter area, is to make sure that you get a fire going, put down a bed so that if you die, you spawn back on the bed and you have some weapons. Now to do that, I'm gonna have to level up. I'm gonna show you that in just a moment. I gotta admit though, I'm liking the graphics up on Ultra. I originally set them too high because I didn't want to push it too hard and I was having those issues. I'm glad I went ahead and uninstalled a couple of those items. Oh boy. Restarted my system and tried this again. It's so much nicer now. Even all those sticks I've picked up, I already used enough. I only have 6 sticks left. I'm definitely going to be grabbing every stick I can see. You'll see why here in just a moment. I think I need a few more. And this is a good area to gather from. There's no enemies in this area. There's nothing that's going to attack. The only problem is food and water. And I have a water skin and I've collected 20 grubs or bugs so far. I can eat those bugs. I mean, it's not the tastiest thing in the world, but it'll keep me from dying. And food and hunger will kill you in this game very quickly. Keep an eye on your food meter. Keep an eye on your water meter. Now, even though I'm playing a local solo co-op game, I still have to create a server to do so. And the server actually is online. I put a password on it so nobody just jump into my game. But that means I can set up server settings. So I can make it easier or harder. I can increase the amount of experience I get or the amount of resources I get from gathering. I haven't changed anything. The game settings are exactly the same. The only thing I did change was that characters that log out stay in the world. I don't want that. I don't want to be logged into the world when I'm not actually playing the game. I don't think it should matter because I'm playing a local game, but I don't, you know, I never know. And that's the only setting that I changed. Now, it's not that I will never play online. I'll play a controlled. If it's a group of friends playing online, I'm fine with that. I don't want to do the open world servers. My experience with those kind of servers are not very pleasant, and I don't ever want to do them again. So, and it wasn't with this game, but you know, past experiences. Now, I think if you read the first note, you can't read the second note. As I have yet to be able to read the second note. Unless, once again, this one is tied to the fact that I've turned off the music and that's why I can't hear the speak. I'll have to see. I'll put it in the annotations. I'll put a note in there for you and let you know what I find out. Alright, well, I'm done in the starter area. I'm gonna go ahead and get closer to what's called the Oasis. It's the area that most people reach. Now, you can go over that way, and you can go over that way. You're still gonna reach the Oasis. It's where there's water, plants, animals, and there are enemies. Things will start trying to kill you. In that area out there, everything's trying, it's Mother Nature, time, and you running out of food and water that's gonna kill you. Here, stuff's gonna attack you. Now this is a little area. I like to use this as a starter base area. But first off, I'm gonna go ahead and level up. Now I've earned 2 levels. As soon as you log in, you get some levels, but I earned another one while I was out there. And the first thing I'm gonna do is get grit. Grit determines the size of your stamina pool. Stamina is very important in this game from what I've seen so far. And then I'm gonna grab vitality because that's my health pool. I'm gonna go here and learn recipes. Now I know how to make the I know how to make this little temple, but I'm not going to worry about that. That's way out in the future right now. Nothing I need to worry about at this moment. I know how to make stone picks and improvised torch, and I can weave, and that allows me to, if I want to, pick these items up. What I'm going for is the apprentice craftsman, because that's going to open up all this. You hear that heartbeat? That heartbeat means that I'm dying, and at this point, it's because of water. So I'm going to take two drinks, and I know I'm going to run out of food soon, so I'm going to go ahead and eat a lot of these bugs. So if I didn't pay attention to that, I would have sat there and just died. I would have expired. So make sure you pay attention to that. So I've used my one unlock, and it gave me a stone hatchet, fiber bedroll, and twine. I can make those items now. And it gives me the ability to open up these items and use them, but I have to earn them. And if I want, I can actually reset. That's what that reset all button was at the bottom, but I'm not gonna do that right now. So the first thing I'm going to do is craft up a little bit more fiber. I'm gonna craft up some twine so I can craft my bedroll. I need to put that down soon. And now I'm gonna craft an axe. And that's a weapon I can use. It's probably a better weapon than the stone pick. And then I'm gonna go ahead and put down my bedroll. And then I have to hit E to set my spawn point. Because if I don't, when I die, and I will die, I won't spawn on my bed, I'll spawn at a random location. Okay, that side jump is you hold it and then hit shift. Hold it and then hit shift. If you hold shift and then move, it's a running maneuver. All right, so that's an imp, and it's seen me, and it's going to attack. Oh, well, I tried to dodge. I'll figure that eventually. I haven't gotten the dodging down very good. Hence why I want to do a ranged character. Now, I got some flesh from him, and I got some hide and bone. All very good stuff. So I'm just running around, I'm gathering some resources that I know I'm going to need. Oh, I've got a chance. And as I'm doing this, I'm getting experience. And I've already gained another level. So this next level, I'm gonna put into encumbrance, allowing me to carry more. That's also very important. I'll go ahead and learn recipes. And I'm going to learn how to make a fire. So that's very important. I can make more water skins, and I can make a campfire. Now to craft a campfire, I need 50 branches and 30 stone. I've got the stone easy. I need more branches. So I'm gonna go down and cut down more trees. Now my axe is about to break, and I can repair it, and it'll cost me stone to do so. Cut down this tree, then I'll go repair it real quick. So I click on the axe, and I hit repair. And it eats up some stone, and it gives me back a repaired stone axe. Fortunately, I'm not getting a lot of... I'm getting wood. Okay, no, I'm getting some branches. How many more? I need 20 more branches. Now, that's I believe it's called a shellback. Unless you steal its eggs, hurt its young, or get too close to it, it shouldn't attack you. Imps will come charging at you from afar. These guys mainly leave you alone as long as you leave them alone. But you get too close to them, or you attack them, their young, or steal their eggs, they'll come after you. Their eggs make really good food, though. Because you don't have to cook it. Now that flesh I picked up, I can eat that flesh raw, but if I do, or when I do, I will get food poisoning. Food poisoning can kill you. Alright. Bro, because I'm going to repair it. I just need a few more branches. Nope, don't punch the tree. Almost there. Now that animal right there, they are very, oops, I'm carrying too much. Can't move. I'm gonna drop that wood off. Click on it and drop. That way I can move. I need to get water. I was getting really close to dying. Now go in here and hit E, and I can drink. But if I hit 7, I'll fill up my water skin and also drink at the same time. So that's convenient. Oh, I pissed one off and he's chasing me. Run for the hills. Those guys are no joke. I do not want to mess with them right now. I do not need to die. Go ahead and gather while I'm running. Oop, ran out of stamina. Well, fortunately, if I die, I've got my bedroll right here, so. Oh, I got a human on me too. This isn't good. Well, I told you I was gonna die. I'm not one to lie to you guys. I am going to die. Figured if I'm gonna die, I might as well gather resources while I'm dying. At least when I come back, I'll be able to make a fire. Now, what I don't know is if I die, I'm going to be spawning right over there. Are those guys still going to be there? Ooh. So I'm going to get a little distance. Hoping I can get those two to fight each other. That would be beneficial for me. I was trying to dodge. I haven't really learned the dodge yet. It keeps beating on me. Quit beating me. Come on, I'm dead already. Go bother something else. No, he's still there. Shale back is what it's called.
Oh, and that guy's still there too.
Dude, that's not cool. Now my bedroll disappears. The bedroll is only useful for one use, so keep that in mind. We learned a couple things there. One, my placement of my bedroll wasn't a smart one. Oh, okay, good. Like, tell me I can loot. I can double click my stuff on. Nice. That's very nice. I'm glad that I can double click my stuff on. Oh, come on. That's bull. Though I should have anticipated it. I'm gonna shift areas. I'm gonna go ahead and shift areas. I have enough sticks. Yep. I don't have enough. My meat went bad. Now, raw meat in this game only lasts so long, then it goes putrid. You don't want to eat the green meat. Don't eat the green meat, kiddies. So, I'm going to come over here. think I can get away with putting something up here and I'll be okay. Yeah, that's not bad. And there's the way up and down. I can put my house up here. So I'm gonna use this area as a shelter. Ooh, I even found an area where it's giving me a little bit of shelter. Not enough to actually shelter me. I have to build that, but go ahead and build a fire. I always wanted to show you this. So I have to craft the fire. I'm going to craft some more twine up so that I can make another bedroll. And it only works once. Once you've used the bedroll, you've got to make another one. Now you can craft actual beds. I've seen that on a stream. Now when I got the fire open, I'll go ahead and put the meat in. I'll put some wood in and then turn it on. So this right here on the right-hand side is a tutorial, how do you use it? You put wood in, you put the meat in, you turn it on, and then this is your crafting cube. This is showing you what's being crafted right now. Now, I don't know if this is intended, but for right now, this does work. I can use the fire's inventory as a storage area for all this. I don't have to carry it with me. That's very convenient, because weight isn't as it is here. Now we're going to turn everything off. I don't want to burn all the wood up that's in there. Then I go back to my inventory, and I'm not going to eat it right now. I don't need it yet. If I eat it right now, it's just a waste. This putrid meat, I'm just going to drop it. I don't know if it disappears. We'll find out. Click and place my bedroll and spawn point updated. So that's my spawn point. So now I have food and water. I've got a reliable water source down there. If I'm careful, I can hunt. And once I get a little stronger, I can take on the shalebacks. And I can eat their eggs too for food. This is running much smoother. I'm even on a lot better graphics than I was before. I mean, those graphics are awesome. And no, I'm not talking about the other things. I'm talking about the graphics. The graphics are awesome. The game is running much smoother. Give Conan a chance. Make sure there's nothing else running in the background. I didn't do that the first time, and I jumped on the bandwagon of this game sucks. And it doesn't. And it's not fair to the developer. It's not fair to the other people that like this game. Find out what the problem is, address it, correct it, and the game is running nice. Now, I'm not playing online. I'm not playing in one of the open servers. That's a big difference. If I was playing there, I would be having a lot of rubber banding. I was so upset because I was playing a solo game to avoid that, and I was having other problems that I shouldn't be having. It was on my end, it wasn't the game. Wanted to make sure that was said. I am critical. This has been a first look at Conan Exiles. There's gonna be much more to come on this game. This game is going to become a staple of my channel. I'm never gonna compete with everybody else playing this game, but I hope to do it in my own special way. Thank you for being here. You have a nice day. Take it easy.